Okay guys, now let us talk about an experiment which is called FLIP or fluorescent loss in photo bleaching. Okay, so in this case what we can look in this experiment, this experiment has been done to prove the mortality of phospholipid molecules in cell membrane. So again, as it was suggested by Singer and Nicholson, according to their model of fluid mosaic nature, is that these phospholipids are not stable, they are motile, they can move from one place to another place via the lateral movement as well as the flip-flop movement. So suppose we have this membrane, how can we prove this movement using this kind of experiment? So what is the experiment? The experiment is a simple, is based on a simple common sense. That is, we have a cell and we have to tag these phospholipids with different fluorescent dye. So in this case we use the phosphate as a radioactive legend. Okay, so we tag with radioactive phosphate, which will give us the fluorescence dye, or we can use a fluorescent dye to tag it. Different kinds of fluorescent dye can be used in this case. So use fluorescent dye. Now what we can look in this case, we can either we can do in both ways. We can use phosphate as radioactive to check radioactivity, or we can take fluorescence, but this experiment is done with the fluorescence tag. So we use fluorescence tag and we tag all of the phospholipids which are present in the cell membrane of this cell. Now after that, what we use a laser, which is a high power laser beam. We use a laser beam, we expose a particular surface area of this cell membrane to this laser beam, and what it does, it bleach some area. What it mean by bleach? It bleach means it some of the area of the cell membrane have lost the fluorescence activity. So it is called the bleach. So if we think this is the cell membrane, then this area has been bleached by using those laser beam. And now what we are doing according to our to prove our experiment, we have to measure the fluorescence in some other place of the cell irrespective of where it has been done. So in this case, suppose this place, this white place, has been bleached by this by the exposure of laser beam. So we have to measure the amount of fluorescence in this area, which is shown here. So we keep measuring the fluorescence in this area. So what we can see is that the fluorescent activity is being decreased in this area. So why the fluorescence activity will be decreased in this area? Because the actual concept is about that. So this area is being bleached. So this area is not being bleached. So there is no way that the fluorescence activity of this area can be reduced. The only possible way that this area can be reduced is that if the cell membrane component or cell membrane phospholipid which has been present here is start to move into this unbleached place, this bleached area actually. And that is what happening. So that's why this the fluorescence activity in this area is being decreased. So that's what we are talking about. So if we continue bleach this area, if we continue bleaching this area, we measuring the activity, we finally see that after some time the overall area of the cell is being bleached. But we cannot expose, we did not expose the whole cell membrane to the laser beam. But still the overall part of the cell is being bleached because of the movement of those phospholipid molecules. So those phospholipid molecules are rapidly moving. If they are not rapidly moving, then this kind of bleach fall or this kind of photoreactivity fall cannot be shown. So if we note our data, if we put our data and make a graph with that, then you can finally see this is the fluorescence in this y-axis, and in the x-axis we have time. So irrespective of time, we can see the fluorescence activity is being decreased. So the fluorescence activity, which is previously here when the cell is not being bleached, then after the cell is bleached, so here in this point the cell is bleached, and after the cell is bleached, the phospholipid layer is bleached, then we can see the fall in the fluorescent activity. And that can only be possible because the area from where we can take the data is not the area where it is bleached. It's the area somewhere else in the cell. That means there is some effect is shown in this area if something happens to this. So if we do something here, that will reflect throughout the whole of the cell membrane. That means the whole cell membrane is connected, because what a if a phospholipid molecule present here, now that can be present there yesterday, or that can be present here tomorrow. So that's actually the basic idea. So what is present? Nothing is stable in its particular point. So they can, all of these molecules are in rapid motion. They can be transferred from one place to another place. They can move from one place to another place, and that's the basic idea about the Singer and Nicholson model. And that's a very, very important assumption, because of this nature of motility, because of this nature of motility from one place to another place, gives the cell membrane a very good activity, very sol-like nature, or a fluid nature. And this fluid nature helps the cell membrane to transport different molecules, not only to transport different molecules but to carry out the signal transduction. Because in signal transduction, they need to be there are different protein molecules to be attached with each other for surveying or relaying a particular message. So that's why this phenomenon is really good, really very important. And FLIP is an experiment that helps us to establish this concept.